Hi everyone, welcome to week two of Pink Movember. Today we're gonna go over the workout for week two. We have six exercises. Let's just make sure we warm up for about 5 to 10 minutes. And then after we've gone through the workout, you wanna make sure you cool down for at least 5 minutes and follow that up with a full body stretch.
All right guys, so our first exercise of the day is a bridge pulse. So you're just gonna find a nice soft spot on the floor. If you've got a mat, great. We'll go ahead and lie down on it. We're gonna make sure our feet are flat on the floor, about hip width apart. We're gonna have our arms out to the side for support if we need them. And all we're gonna do is think about keeping that core pulled in nice and tight. And we're gonna come up, squeeze our hamstrings and our glutes in toward each other, and then come back down. And back up. And all the way back down each time. Now if this is a little too easy for you, you can go into a single leg hip bridge pulse. All I want you to do is think about straightening one leg out. The other foot stays flat on the floor. We're going to think about driving that heel straight up toward the ceiling. So we're using whatever foot is flat on the floor to drive up, squeeze your hamstring and your glute, and come back down. And back up, and back down. We'll go for 10 reps on one side and then 10 reps on the other. All right, guys, so our next exercise is a seated reverse fly. So you're gonna find a chair or a bench, something that doesn't roll around or spin around on you. Go ahead and take a seat right in the center of it. Feet are gonna be flat on the floor. Core is gonna be pulled in tight, top of that head up toward the ceiling. You're gonna grab your weights, bend your elbows at a 90 degree angle. Palms are gonna be facing toward you. You want your elbows to stay in line with your shoulders the whole time. We don't want them way up here, and we don't want them dropping down here either. So, core is pulled in tight, top of the head up toward the ceiling. Palms facing us. As we come out, our palms are gonna rotate and face away. We're gonna think about squeezing our shoulder blades toward each other when we come back into this position. Back into the center, and then back out nice and slow. Two count on the way out, two count on the way back in. Nice deep breaths the whole time.
All right guys, so now we're on to our wall sit. So what you wanna do is you wanna find a wall and you're just gonna go ahead and lean up against it here. And we're just gonna slowly walk our feet out. We're gonna have them about hip width apart. And we're just gonna walk out until we feel like we're in a position where once we come down into the wall sit, our knees are gonna be directly over our heels. We don't ever want them coming past our toes like this. Puts a lot of strain and pressure on those knees. So again, start in that upright position, slowly walk those feet out, make sure they're hip width apart. And then once we get here, we're just gonna bend our knees and come down to a position where we feel our muscles working. Now, that might be right here, just a slight bend. Or if it's a little too easy, you can always come down until you're in parallel with the floor. So and from here, you're just gonna keep that back flat up against the wall and no hands, because we don't wanna use them to help us by pushing on our legs. And we're just gonna take nice deep breaths the whole time. All right, so from our wall sit, we're gonna move on to negative push-ups. Now there's a few different variations of this one. The first one would be a negative push-up on the wall. So you're gonna be in the same position you were in for that regular push-up last week. You're gonna have your hands about shoulder width apart, making sure they're not any higher up than even with your shoulders. Core is pulled in tight. We're gonna step those feet back just a little bit. And all we're gonna do is we're gonna focus on coming down nice and close to the wall as slow as we can. We'll hold for about a second once we get down to this position, and then we're gonna push ourselves back up at a normal pace. So the negative part of it comes in the very beginning when we're lowering ourselves down just as slow as we can. Alright, so the next progression in the negative push-up series would be an elevated negative push-up. So again, find something nice and sturdy, such as a countertop. Your hands are going to be on it. We're just going to slowly walk our feet back, keep that core pulled in tight, and we're going to have our hands about shoulder width apart, and we're just going to come down as slow as we possibly can, and regular speed on the way back up. On the way down, normal on the way back up. Inhale on your way down, exhale on your way back up. If that's still a little bit too easy,
gonna go ahead and do the same thing but on the floor. So hands are right underneath our shoulders, core is folded tight, hips are in line with the rest of our body. Just coming down nice and slow. Leading with our chest. And normal pace on the way back up. All right guys, so for this next exercise, we're gonna be on a mat and it's gonna be a boat pose. So all we're gonna do is be on a mat. We're gonna kind of keep our feet flat on the floor to start out with. And we're just gonna have our hands out at our sides, palm facing up toward the ceiling, not making a fist because that's gonna put a lot of energy and strength into your arms rather than focusing on your core. So all I want you to do is think about leaning back until you find that spot between your tailbone and your lower back where you feel balanced. And we're just gonna hold it here, nice deep breath the whole time. If this doesn't feel challenging enough, you can certainly feel free to bring those feet up off the floor, keeping that core pulled in tight. Shoulders are gonna be back so we're not rounding here. Nice deep breaths. If this is still a little too easy for you, go ahead and straighten those legs out and hold it right here. Nice deep breaths the whole time. All right, and finally, last but certainly not least, is fast feet. So this one, you're just gonna be right here, keeping that core pulled in tight again, but remembering to breathe. We're gonna have our hips back just a little bit, hands out in front of us, and we're just moving those feet as quick as we can. They're barely coming up off the floor. Right here. Just 30 seconds of this. Now, if this is a little too high impact, you can certainly just switch it up into a slow, high knee march, getting those arms moving at our sides. Totally up to you.